Hello, 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 assalamu alaikum, jianu, pakhair agale, nihao, chune shumme, washmale, ohaya gonzaimus, guten morgen, hi, hugs and hellos to everybody who's out there, and khush amadeed, thank you very much for tuning into PT World, you watch it well this morning, alongside Shahzad Khan and Maha Makhtoom. Hello Maha, how are you?
Hello Shahzad, assalamu alaikum everyone. I'm feeling better today. Every day I think I get a little bit better and I'm looking forward to the weekend because then that way I can have a full rest.
And I think it's just because of me, because when you've got such an energetic Aleem right next to you, obviously you'll feel great, right?
Oh yeah, exactly. You do cheer me up quite a lot. That's why I've been coming into work, otherwise I would not be. But no, apart from that, everything's good. And Shahzad, I think we have a very big show today, so I feel like we should
we've got a very important show, and yes, obviously we'll start, but you know, for all those people who are out there, you know, starting to rise and shine, wake and bake, you know, get up, get, you know, make sure that you inhale all of the positivity you have within your own self and then exhale all the laziness which you might behold because of the fact that you've been sleeping. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment when you make a difference in your life. This is this day which you've actually got is a blessing from God because of the fact that you can make or probably bring about quite a lot of changes and differences within your own life and the people who surround you.
Wonderful. And you know, I really wish we could lead into the topic like that, but no, we can't. Unfortunately, we have to do our headlines first. So I will start with the headlines.
Yes.
So Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif has invited Bahraini investors to explore investment opportunities in the commercial and tourism sectors of Pakistan. So that's really good that we're able to reach out to people and actually say, come and invest with us.
Yeah.
So that's good.
And the next one, what do you have?
The next one, Turkey has also reaffirmed its full support and solidarity for Pakistan on all issues and reiterated resolve to further fortify bilateral relations. So that's great. You know, hopefully positive things will come out of that.
Exactly. That's what it is. And that's how the course was already. But now moving on to sports, ladies and gentlemen. Pakistan will face West Indies today in second T20 format series at Queen's Park Oval in Trinidad. PTV Sports will telecast the match live from 9:30 p.m. onwards. Well, in fact, I think since we are a cricketing nation, everybody might be looking forward to these cricket matches as well. And then just another news, and that is that, you know, Mohammed Irfan, who has been recently banned just because of the fact that he was involved in spot fixing, says that I am sorry, but I accept my mistake and I say sorry to my fans. I think that's a great deal to accept your own mistake in the
Absolutely.
First place.
Absolutely. So that was the headlines. And actually today we're going to do a public service message at the end of the show.
All right, whatever you say, you know, ladies.
Today we've got a very important subject. As you know, we like to highlight different areas, different things. And we like to highlight people visiting Pakistan as well. Because it's about how people... This show is also about breaking perceptions. It's about breaking the idea that Pakistan is a very dangerous place. There's, you know, it's people cannot visit, etc. But we've shown you over the last 3.5 years that that's not true. A lot of positive work is happening here. A lot of people are doing a lot of work, and there's a lot of cross-cultural things going on in regards to education, culture, political, all these things.
But other than that, ladies and gentlemen, today what primarily we are focusing on is obviously women empowerment, first of all, because we do have people who are experts in social work. And now under the umbrella of social work, there can be quite a lot of things as well. For example, youth development, women empowerment, and then so on and so forth as well. Now we do have experts, and then we do have people who are becoming experts of this field as well. And they're not from our country, they're from somewhere abroad where they have been studying, but they do belong to different regions of the globe.
Exactly.
So I think what we'll be able to do is that we'll be able to share figures and facts from different areas and different regions of the world, and then we'll obviously present our facts and figures and see which areas we can probably be helpful with each
other. Yeah, exactly, because in Pakistan there is a, you know, I mean, for me personally, I know what social work is in England. You become a social worker, you go out into the less, into the more deprived areas and you help them fix their lives. You know, you work with families, you work with children. Whereas in Pakistan, I haven't seen the official work. I'm sure there are people out there who are doing this, but we haven't really highlighted it, and I think it's really important to highlight this. So we've been very lucky. We've been joined from people who have been who've come all the way from America. They are representing a university. They're representing the Northeastern Illinois University of Chicago. I'll tell you that now because afterwards I am going to shorten it. So we've been joined by Professor Jade Stanley. She is a chairperson of the Social Work Department of the University of Northeastern Illinois University, Chicago. Yeah. Hello, assalamu alaikum, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having us here today.
Thank you. Besides Professor Jade Stanley, we've been joined by Omer Alba. He is a student of NEIU Chicago, and he is also a student of social work, but we'll find out what your major is when we start the conversation. Assalamu alaikum, good morning.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us. I mean, your major is social work, but the specific area you're focusing on. Besides Omer, we've been joined by Kim Miller. She is also a student of NEIU Chicago, and she's also in the social work studies. Assalamu alaikum, good morning. Hello.
Good morning, and thanks so much for having me.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Love the energy.
Besides Kim Miller, we've been joined by Nicole Babini. She's also a student of the university, and she is also majoring in social work. Assalamu alaikum, hello, good morning.
Thank you
for joining us.
So when we say assalamu alaikum, we are trying to greet you, and the answer is wa alaikum assalam.
Wa alaikum assalam.
So this is the first gift you're going to get from Pakistanis. That's what it is. But thank you very much for coming over. And it's a pleasure to have you over here and to host you inside Pakistan as well. Thank you very much once again. But to get started with the conversation, for all those people who are out there, why are you guys here?
As part of the university, we are cultural ambassadors. Mm. And we are here to form and maintain a relationship with UMT. Mm-hmm. To work on social development, to look through the lens of women, children, and communities, mm-hmm. and to try to bring about change that's better for those at the margin so that they can come to the center.
Okay, amazing.
Me and Umar are left out because there was no man in it, right?
yes, that's true.
Okay, so you're gonna.
But they're part of the story too.
Oh, okay, wonderful. So now, in regards to social work, what do we mean when we say social work?
So social work in the United States has a history in England, actually, and it's really to bring opportunities to people who are often left out mm-hmm. of the general conversation and of the general opportunities in life. Mm-hmm. Many countries call it social development, mm-hmm. but it's very much the same. Indeed. And social work is divided into an undergraduate program and a graduate program. Okay. Students in the undergraduate program are called generalists, okay. and they're trained to be able to work with a variety of individuals, groups, families, and communities. Mm-hmm. And in the master's program, then they become specialized. Okay. And they might work in mental health.
Okay, amazing.
Okay, but over here, I think what is more important to know is, why do you think in the first place, and I think I'm going to pose this as a challenge for all your students who are over here as well, why do you think that we do always have a set of people who are not given those opportunities, and they are left out, and that's what when we actually call it that, you know, whenever we're going to help them or make it possible for them to, you know, avail an opportunity, that's what we call social work, right?
Yes.
Why in the first place? Is it the social net of the community? Is that how we process? Is that how we program? That most of the time there are people or a group of people who are left out always.
So why are they left out, basically? Why are there people?
So your question is a very important one.
Thank you.
And that is why we're here in Pakistan, so that we can begin to understand that and kind of pull back the onion to kind of understand the different layers of why those kinds of situations happen. We know in the United States that oftentimes that there's the haves and the have-nots. Mm-hmm. And so as social workers, we're trying to help people help themselves and move through the avenue so that they can be productive members of society. Mm-hmm. Why that occurs is a very complex question.
It is.
But it's something that has been at the very core of the work that I do, mm-hmm. to try to understand that so that we can bring about change, and I think it can move to harmony mm-hmm. and peace. And I think that's one of the bigger opportunities for us to be in Pakistan to understand that, mm-hmm. because we have been led to believe that that's very different than what happens in the United States.
Okay, so let's move on to Omer. Now, what are you focusing on in regard in when you're in your social work?
So we are graduating in May, three of us here. Great. And part of our last year, we have to complete internship hours.
Okay.
So I currently work, my full-time job is I work in the child welfare system.
Okay, wonderful.
And then my internship is working with population that it's living with HIV.
Okay, amazing.
So my focus here is definitely children.
And HIV.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, over your visit so far, what have you seen? Have you seen that it's very different, like Professor Jade has just mentioned, mm-hmm. that you've made to believe it's very different situations. Is it? So what is your...
So the situation with children, I think it's different because the focus, it's different.
Okay.
And that's something that I really, really liked.
Okay.
It's very interesting to see the focus that children are giving in the U.S. versus children here in Pakistan.
Okay. Which is what?
For example, in the U.S., children are placed in different homes, foster homes.
Okay.
Right. Here in Pakistan, what I've noticed is that mostly women are the ones that guide children.
Okay.
We went to, for example, the Bureau. The Child Welfare Bureau. Mm-hmm. So that's something that I noticed.
Yeah.
Or SOS Village, for example.
Yeah.
So the model is very different. And that's something that's very interesting.
Okay.
Because we can probably implement it.
Okay, now in regards to that, like what you've been seeing, are you seeing these are positive things or negative things in regards to the social work?
It is, I think it's positive.
Yeah.
Because we are all open to mm-hmm. different ideas. And I think countries should be open to ideas from other countries.
Okay.
So I think it's definitely positive.
Okay, wonderful.
But there's one more thing which I'm observing right now, and it is obviously not very... I don't think that it's a good idea to talk about that, but I think that it's going to be very amazing because what I'm trying to observe over here is very different from what we are discussing.
Mm.
And that is it because that, you know, you came to Pakistan and then when you guys were roaming around, probably you witnessed that, you know, quite a lot of ladies, they covered themselves with a shawl or mm-hmm. a dupatta. And both of you are actually carrying a dupatta too as well. Is it the effects of Pakistan or you always carry it?
Sorry, this is a very random.
This piece of cloth, which is around your neck as well. We call it a dupatta, right?
We're from Chicago.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're from Chicago, and Chicago is a very diverse city. And so we actually had all of these things with us. We haven't been able to go shopping since we've been here. So,
so
that's in our
choice.
List. Yes.
Okay, wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Amazing.
Amazing. Now, coming back to the topic.
Yeah. And Chicago is an amazing city as well. They call it the windy city. Yeah, I've been to Chicago.
Excellent.
The downtown's the coolest place ever.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Wonderful. We're hopefully going to talk about Chicago as a place as well. But let's move on to Kim.
Yeah.
Tell us, what is your focus in social work?
Okay. My focus as a social worker is working with the impoverished communities, families. My target is women.
Okay.
Back in the United States, my internship is at an organization called Girls in a Game.
Okay.
And we help women, I mean girls, I'm sorry, become leaders.
Right.
So I'm actually going to grad school and my concentration will be leadership. So that looks like developing programs, developing models that can help the community, that can help the family system, and that can help just people in general that who've been...
So what type of programs do you already have in your head that you know, okay, this might be probably helpful for the community?
Well, because gangs and drugs and violence is such a big lens in Chicago, I would like to come up with something for youth boys between the ages of 12 and 18, and that's where the gangs, violence, and the drugs, and the dropout rates, it starts there.
Right.
So I was thinking more so of like a vegetable farm that they could help raise the... vegetables and then sell them and make money, you know.
So, and all I can think of is the movie Dictator when probably he gets kicked out. So he goes to a girl where she's kitchen gardening or something of that sort, and he kind of tries to help her with that as well. So I think that's a brilliant idea.
There's
a healthy one as well.
And it's a good way to keep them busy, and those are the crucial ages. Now, in regards to your visit, seeing what's, you see what's happening in Chicago, now you come to Pakistan. What are the things that you're picking up in which both countries could maybe learn from each other?
Well, I actually came with a very open mind, and I do see that the family system is truly important here. I also see that education is really on the top of the list. I have to just say that I thought that Pakistanians came to the United States for education. I didn't realize that there is education here and that they're so resilient and how educated they are here.
Oh, wonderful, that's great. Okay, now, but the thing is in regards to the impoverished communities, because that we have those here as well, how do you, what kind of things do you think you can pick up which we can learn from each other? Like, I mean, just kind of solutions maybe, or is that too, are we too far, you know.
Or do you think that the problems we have over here are similar to the problems which might prevail in the community over there?
Well, sure they are. Just the, like we visit some orphanages, like Abbey orphanages, and I just think that the work that they do over here is phenomenal, that they put a lot of emphasis on the children. And I do believe that they are our future, and so that if we take control of them now, that we give them a way to lead the, our, you know, the country.
Okay, wonderful. Okay, so Nicole, tell us about your focus in your
major. Okay, so back in home in Chicago, I work with young girls, teaching them how to communication skills, leadership, and self-confidence. Okay. So here my focus has been women empowerment, and we visit a lot of NGOs that focus on.
Okay, now tell me one thing, because this is, I'm taking over this conversation. I'm so sorry, Shazad. But tell me one thing. You know, people have this idea of women in Pakistan being very repressed, very, you know, kind of sidelined, etc. Now, the way America has projected itself is that women have equal rights, everything's great, you know, America is the place to go. Now, when you get people from abroad and they're talking about working on women's rights in these countries, what problems do you guys face still, which are similar to ours, and how do you see the difference? Like, because it's very interesting.
Yeah, I think that there's the Western view, which you know, you have to kind of take a step back when you're in a different country. That is not, they come from different cultures, different religions, and so you have to understand that, and that, like, wearing the covering your head and wearing those things, that's a personal choice. That's not forced upon you. That is your expression of religion, which I'm all for that.
Yeah.
I think there's also similarities. It's not equal in the U.S. The pay is not equal. There's not as many women in leadership roles. Girls at a young age are taught, like, through society, that it's not okay to say their opinions. You know, it's about your looks, not about your thoughts and your feelings. And I think that's common here too.
Okay.
And so I guess where my focus is to try to work on young girls to get them that confidence to say that they have a voice and it's okay to say your voice.
Okay. I also think in regard to making the women's voice being heard, everyone needs to value that voice.
Yes.
Exactly, and it's not just about women anyway. It's like that, you know, everybody's got this freedom to speak whatever they want to speak. I mean, they can voice their concerns. But other than that, I think, since you just mentioned that, you know, you're working on women empowerment, and confidence plays a very key role. It plays a very pivotal role as well.
Mm.
Now, over here, generally within the community, I think it is not probably the community's responsibility to give you that confidence or probably support you with all of what you think. I think it starts from your home.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the grassroots level of it. I mean, what do you think precisely goes wrong in your childhood, or what type of nurturing do you get which actually makes you not to be very confident in your household?
I think it's when you have parents tell you, like, oh, you shouldn't say that, or you can't do this, or that you're wrong. And as a child, you should be encouraged to speak your mind, even if it's, say, incorrect, but you should still be encouraged to say that. You know, it's when you tell your kids that they can't do something. I think that's
when they do it.
That's exactly.
That's when they're most vulnerable.
I feel like, Jade, you wanted to add something in regards to this women empowerment.
I was thinking about your question and how that has led me to develop these short-term study tours and the cultural exchange, because I believe, based on your question, is that the only way that we can really learn from one another is to interact with one another and to try to change perceptions and to try to change how we view each other.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that March is Social Work Month, and it's also Women's History Month, and so it's a very important time for women to look at their agenda, see what their issues are, see how we can globally work together so that we can bring about change, so that women can have a voice. And I think, going back to perceptions, we've been to many of the agencies throughout Lahore and Islamabad, and women are in very key roles, and I believe that's going to be part of how Pakistan moves forward. And I do believe that as an American woman, that I can learn from those experiences, and as I'm here and I share my story, that the Pakistani women can also see what I've been able to accomplish. And so that's just the beginning of a dialogue and the beginning of an opportunity so that we can change perspectives.
Exactly.
And
that's what we are doing over here as well. I think for all those people who are out there You obviously, and all of you, thankfully, thank God that you guys are here. You are a source of inspiration for all those people who are out there. But Umar, I've got a thing for you. And now that is, since you're working with all those people who are affected with HIV as well, and then mm-hmm. there are young kids, right? Mm-hmm. Now, as a matter of fact, you know, Professor, she very correctly mentioned that it's all about changing perceptions. Now, other than changing perceptions, I think the world we live in is all about marketing now. Mm-hmm. Now, whenever we talk about women empowerment, whether we talk about youth development, whatever kind of social work, because that's what we are discussing, how do you think that what kind of marketing strategies can be very helpful in changing the mindsets of the people or the perceptions?
I think, just like Dr. Stanley mentioned, having that exchange, and maybe, for example, we talked about this previously, the places where we visited, having students coming here. Mm-hmm. I think marketing exchange of students, mm-hmm. and that would definitely change perceptions in people, or perceptions have completely changed mm-hmm. us being here.
Yeah.
So I think marketing that, marketing okay. the exchange of students.
Yeah, because I feel like the media is it's kind of mm-hmm. like a tool that's kind of just kind of out of control as itself, so you can't really
use agree.
That. Yeah. So now I think it's more about the grassroots level
that's
than
right,
the
right.
word of mouth type yeah. of situation.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's a shame though.
Yeah.
In addition to that, it's okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Please. No. No.
Okay.
Feel free.
Yeah.
We'll go to you, and then we'll move on to Kim. Yeah.
Okay. Sorry, yeah. Kim.
So no problem. Okay.
So a tangible thing, not necessarily marketing, but a tangible thing is that each student, including myself, we're doing what's called ethnographic research studies.
Okay.
And so when they go back to the United States, they're gonna present mm-hmm. at a research symposium, mm-hmm. and then those pieces of research get to go out into the larger community, and they get to add their voices to news articles, mm-hmm. research articles, that other people begin to understand some of the dynamics that
okay.
they've experienced here.
Yeah, okay, but
that's amazing.
That is amazing. That's a brilliant idea. But initially, don't you think that it gets difficult for all those social workers who are out there under the presidency of Mr. Trump?
Oh, wow.
Yes. Oh, that's a pleasure.
that's like a whole hour.
Yeah, it gets difficult for all those social workers who are out there.
It's difficult for us.
So how are you voicing your concerns then?
This is tough.
Take your time. It's all right.
Thank you.
No problem.
Kim wanted to say something, and then I'll come back.
Yeah, yeah. About the preconceived
notions
that,
yes.
Yeah. And so when I came, or was when I was thinking about coming, I had so many ideas like running through my head. Mm. And my mother was really, really freaked out. And she was like, "Do your pastor know? Mm. You know, Trump said that you all not going to be able to come back to the United States. You're going to be graduating in a month. Mm. Will you make it back for graduation?"
Okay.
And I'm really excited about letting her know that it was just all media hype, right?
Yeah.
And the people are so nice and just so loving, you know, and the hospitality has been outstanding. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it would be good to go back and tell, you know, the United States that it's just talk. It's not really that.
Yeah, it's actually not a bad place. Mm-hmm. It's quite
so good. It does not get difficult?
No.
No.
I think it is difficult.
Yeah.
And it worries us as much as it may worry Pakistanis mm-hmm. and other parts of the world, because it's so much, we're moving into the unknown,
yeah.
and the unknown is kind of unsettling, and
yes.
so
very unsettling.
Gives you quite a lot of anticipation, right?
Yeah.
Anxiety, not anticipation, anxiety.
Yeah. And the timing, the timing was interesting for us, too, as we were planning to come here, because the borders were getting more and more restrictive, and so we were able to get our visas, we were able to come, and I think it's important for Pakistanis to know that we're as concerned as maybe perhaps they are, and that not all people support what is currently going on.
Okay, but then eventually, since you know all of these people are there to, you know, probably you guys are getting ready to help all of those other people who are out there as well. And then another aspect of being a social worker is that you have to be involved within the governmental decision making as well. How do you think that, you know, people over here can probably do that as well, or probably bring them to sit with them on the table and then decide, or probably discuss that this is what we want to do with this chunk of people over here in the community?
Because I feel like social work over here, you know, I feel like they can learn a lot from people where it's an established sector. So you can...
Anybody?
Jade, you start.
I think it's having access. I think it's being able to create avenues so that we can sit in the multiple places in society, and so that voices are heard, and that's all part of the mechanism that brings about change, so that you need to be able to be at the grassroots, to be at the table in academia, to be at the table at the state level in the government area, so that you have a conversation.
Yeah.
And the conversation hopefully leads to action. And we're at a place, I believe, in our society right now where action needs to take place, and that talking is okay, but something needs to happen. And so we want to be part of that change.
But you have that system in America, correct? Yes. Like in the social work system where you have the hierarchy. So everything that you've learned here and you've seen, you can now go back and report it, and it will be taken up to that level where it should be noticed, correct or not?
Correct.
Because it's based on research. I think that's the best part.
That, the research.
You know, for all those people who are out here or, you know, or out there, what happens is that quite a lot of times we all love to quote figures, all that, you know. 97.3% is this, and 62.4% is this, and I'm Mr. All I Know. Or probably, you know, I know it all. But as a matter of fact, for all those people who back their back their documents with quite a lot of research or documents, or, you know, probably even if they have been onto Google or Wikipedia, that does not make a difference. But at least you can form your own opinion based on these statistical figures. And even if it's not really correct, it's going to be somewhere around the figure which you were looking at. So I think make sure that whatever or whenever you speak, make sure that you speak based on the research which you have done or the hard work.
Don't make things up, especially if you're in important positions. But thank you so much for your time. It's been absolutely wonderful having you on the show and discussing.
Thank you so much.
And we're going to have the next batch of guests, and we're going to find out their experiences.
But I think we'll try to make sure that Professor Jade sits with us as well within the next segment, so that she can be helpful for the other half of the students as well.
Great.
So ladies and gentlemen, right now we're going to go for a short break. But when you guys are going to come back, obviously me and Maha are going to share or discuss the problems we have within our community. And then let's see what is their take on that, and what solutions do they have to offer us. So let's go for a short break. Ma, do you want to say good morning?
Stay tuned.
Good morning.
जानना ओ शिनस नाम हुसानना हे सत वतन किन जानना ओ नूरी नसीर खानना हे सत वतन किन जानना अभी वक्त दस्तगीर बराबर वक्त दस्तगीर बराबर नूरी नसीर जान बराबर गाजी नसीर जान बराबर सखी कलंदर बराबर मस्त कलंदर बराबर लालन साईं बराबर वक्त कलंदर बराबर वक्त दस्तगीर बराबर वक्त दस्तगीर बराबर नूरी नसीर जान बराबर गाजी नसीर जान बराबर वाली मेरा खानना हो वाली मेरा खानना हो जी 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 साकना हो जईरियो बल भल जाकना हो जी 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 मंदरी भरी ईच कमा कन तो अंधरी हो जी 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 सुमरो तप फाजो
Welcome back, everyone. And before the break, we were discussing social work, and we've been very lucky to be joined by people from America who are representing the Northeastern Illinois University of Chicago. And they have different focuses in their major of social work. So earlier we saw that people were focusing on family.
HIVs, children, women empowerment.
So now we've been joined by the next batch of students who have also been visiting Pakistan and been exploring. And we've still got been joined by Professor Jade. Thank you so much for staying. Besides Professor Jade, we've been joined by Claudia Lopez. Hello, good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Besides Claudia, we've been joined by Julia Ramirez. Hello, good morning.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here. Besides Julia, we've been joined by Frank Belizer. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Thank you for being here. And besides Frank, we've been joined by Wania McDaniel. Hello. Good
Hello.
Morning.
How are you? I'm good.
Okay, so let's start with you, Claudia. What is your focus in your social work?
Yeah, so back in Chicago, I interned at World Relief Chicago, which is an organization that focuses on immigration.
Immigration.
Yes, it has three specific areas. It has education, it has legalization, and also working with refugees.
Okay, amazing.
Yeah.
So now when you were visiting Pakistan, how was it linked and what did you learn? What did you see?
So here in Pakistan, I think the main focus is working with women and also children. Mm-hmm. So we haven't, personally, I haven't, learned so much about immigration here in Pakistan. Mm-hmm. But here, my focus is women empowerment.
Okay.
And by that being said, it's how different it is in Chicago and here, and how different it is in rural areas and also and the community as well.
We'll definitely come back to that, but let's see what Julia has to say about her work.
Yeah,
wonderful. So mine is a little different. It's on youth development. So in Chicago, I work with youth, primarily high school students. I like focusing on intervention. So these are students who are already involved in gangs, in drugs, who have been previously incarcerated.
Okay.
So we intervene. And so what I liked here in Pakistan is that there are different services that allow them to get their education, to get the support that they need at home. And that was something that I really feel like that I can bring back to Chicago as well.
Amazing. Wow. How about you, Frank? Tell us about yours.
Yes, the work that I do back in Chicago, I do the same work as Claudia. I'm an intern at World Relief Chicago. We focus on refugees, immigrants, and we look at the legal aspect of it.
Okay.
And what I want to do as far as when I become a social worker, I want to work with the youth, and the research I want to do while I'm in Pakistan is to look at students with special needs.
Okay, amazing. And we're going to come back to that as well, because that's very important. Mm-hmm. How about you, Obania? What's about you? What is your focus?
In Chicago, I work with an agency called Facing Forward in Homelessness, and it works primarily with women that are chronically homeless.
Mm-hmm.
But the population that we deal with, they're marginalized, so there's a web of issues that affect them. So I can't necessarily say that I work specifically with this population, because there are all kind of things that affect them. So whatever issues they're facing, we help.
But chronically homeless is such a statement which I have never ever heard before.
No.
Do we refer to it as acute homelessness as well, or are there things like these as well? Wow.
Yes.
I mean, I'm learning today.
Yeah. Wow. That's what you guys say. No, no, but when you say, so I just want you to expand on, so mm-hmm. what are you focusing, like when you're in Pakistan, how is
while in here, while here in Pakistan, yeah. because I work with women at home, yeah. I focused on women empowerment. Yeah. So like my peers before, I came to Pakistan pretty much with an open mind, mm-hmm. and but it was wonderful to see that Pakistanians here mm-hmm. are so liberal. Mm-hmm. So I had to change my idea of what I was mm-hmm. going to mm-hmm. go after being here for a week. Wow. So it's amazing, like seeing that the women here can be empowered with education and economically. So it changed a bit, but
you've made my day. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for saying that. I just wanted to go back to Claudia over here, and you mentioned that, you know, you probably want to do a bit more research in what happens within our provincial areas as well, in the federal and then the urban and then the rural. What are the differences within women empowerment? What are the indicators as well?
Yeah, what I noticed in Chicago and here in Pakistan, in rural areas, they don't have rights. They don't have education, and they are not aware of the organizations that are out there to help them. Right. And also, on the other side, there are women who have education and they know their rights. Like Wania was saying, there are women out there who have a job and they know of the opportunities out there. So that's what I have noticed.
But don't you guys think that it is more amazing to be a woman in Pakistan because you don't get to work at all? At times. Let's see what Professor Doctor has to say.
Yes, we're not very politically correct here. So, anyway, I don't know what to say.
And enjoy all the facilities.
Oh, Shazam.
Yeah.
Anyway. But
that's my job.
Okay. Yes, he brings lighthearted to say. I want to ask you, in regards to, over here you said that in the rural areas, they're not aware of the organizations there, they're not aware of their rights, they don't have as much education as the males. So what is the situation in Chicago?
In Chicago, how
as
women...
Because you're doing mm-hmm. a comparison, right, about the rights that the women have, etc. Mm-hmm. So what are the difficulties that are faced? That are they similar in the America, or are they different?
I feel it's similar.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's about getting education for women.
Yeah.
Then. Okay. Interesting. Mm-hmm. Okay. How about you, Julia? Tell us about.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to talk primarily about youth since that's more my focus. Mm-hmm. But what I really like is essentially the plan is always women and their children. Mm-hmm. So whenever we look at the way that they develop programs, they always keep the children in mind. It's mm-hmm. a unit, and so that's what I like, that whenever they say, okay, well, we're providing the women with loans mm-hmm. so they can provide for their children, mm-hmm. and then. At organizations that focus on women, mm-hmm. they like also servicing the children. Mm-hmm. So we went to a certain foundation that said, okay, well, we give loans to these women, but we also help them with their education. Mm-hmm. And so we give them stipends and things of that nature. So that's what I like, is that it's about a family unit mm-hmm. and it's about helping the home mm-hmm. rather than just an individual. And I think that spreads a lot faster than just concentrating on just
And other than that, whenever we talk about youth development, we do have programs of youth development over here. We have youth internship programs, and then the laptops are given away to all the young mm-hmm. people. But do you think that all of these things help, or the mindset? Because the mindset previously, which was prevailing within our community, was that, okay, you know, if you're not going to study, you're not going to get a job. Don't you think that we need, for example, if we want our youngsters to have a developed mindset or a skill base, don't you think we need to tell them that entrepreneurship can really be helpful in days to come?
Yes, and also what you bring up is one of the key roles in social work is advocacy.
Yes.
So when you advocate on behalf of communities, when you advocate on behalf of women, children, that there's a new mindset that gets stimulated from that experience. So does just a laptop help? No. Mm-hmm. But within that laptop program, what does that mean? Is that an access to a larger community, to the world? But we also know that with all things that are positive, sometimes there's a negative implication that comes from that. And so sometimes, in my experience, when you are more insulated, you don't know what you're missing. And then when you get more exposure to the world, sometimes that changes things. So as Pakistan grows, their issues and their problems might change. Mm. because of the exposure. And so social workers would be able to move into that and to be able to address that.
Amazing.
For example, if that's okay with you, we make a joke about, you know, how BET, you know, comes into a community, or how YouTube or whatever. So your minds expand, and then the community needs to have resources that support that. And so it changes dynamics.
Okay,
but that expansion is very dangerous for quite a lot of people. Yes, I spend most of the time watching sledging videos over the YouTube, you know, within the cricket matches, or probably all of those funny, hilarious fails, or the fail army videos. That's what I do.
What you said, it is a dangerous thing because in certain countries, especially if they're developing, those resources are not there
right.
for them to. Because then you'll feel frustrated in your environment. But now, Frank, you know, you're also focusing on similar to Claudia, correct, about immigration and
yes.
youth. Now, what do you want to take back? And, you know, what can we learn from each other? What kind of potential solutions, potentially, are you seeing while you've been here?
In my time here, with the students with special needs, UMT has a program that works with students with special needs.
Okay, great.
And some of those students end up getting PhDs and teaching the program, so that was very motivating, because growing up, I was in special ed.
Okay.
And with students with special needs, like, it doesn't mean that they're, like, they're equal to everybody else, and they
exactly.
have something to bring to the table as well.
Yeah.
And it's important to let them know that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So then what you're thinking about is inclusive education, right? That's what it is. Do you think that in days to come, we're going to probably witness that all around the globe?
So what's happening, what is the situation in America with special education and people with special needs?
So they're talking about inclusion. And so we asked that question at one of the agencies that I was asking, do students have separate classes? Are they included?
Yeah.
And so in Chicago specifically, but throughout the United States, there's a big move for inclusion and that students have opportunities to learn among their peers.
Oh, right. So right now it's separate in
Pakistan.
We know in Pakistan it's separate, but what we're talking about, I'm asking about
so in some right. So in some communities it still is, but there's a big, large trend that moves us.
So the similar hurdles that we both face. I mean, no one's actually reached that goal that they, everything's perfect.
And you know, the best part today, ladies and gentlemen, is that quite a lot of times we do not really pay quite a lot of attention to social work. Mm-hmm. Now, the only reason and the sole purpose to have them, these young people and vibrant people, to be on the show was so that all those people who are out there, whether you be in Pakistan or somewhere abroad as well, because the channel goes out in 45 different countries across the globe as well, alhamdulillah. Mm-hmm. So now, as a matter of fact, I think collectively we need to make efforts. Collectively we need to learn about things, and then we have to progress and then prosper into the right direction.
Exactly. And I know there is social work going on in Pakistan, but we need to also get our Pakistani social workers on here because they are also doing quite a lot of work. But now, because we're really short of time, but Wenya, what would you like to take back from your visit to Pakistan?
Well, one of the things that I'd like to take back to Pakistan with me is the whole idea that things work as a collective.
Yeah.
I noticed that Pakistani culture, it's about community. One cannot move on or progress without the other.
Okay.
So I like the models that when we visit NGOs, they're family-centered.
Okay.
Services work when the family is working.
Exactly.
And in Chicago, we work on a vulnerability scale.
Mm.
So it's pretty much every man for himself with how they are as a person. So it works, but some issues or some situations it doesn't.
So you want it to be all for one or one for all. That's it.
Great. And unfortunately you've run out of time. Thank you so much for being here. It's an absolute pleasure having you on the show. And I hope the rest of your visit is really enjoyable and good.
And please do go out for shopping as well. Amazing malls over here.
You
can
check it out. You do look fabulous.
Thank you.
But ladies and gentlemen, this is it. This is it for now, but right now we have to move on towards the dry fruit of the day.
Yes, quickly, because we've already
picked up on pistachios.
Yes, pistachios. So,
let's see what are the health benefits.
Okay, so they're good if you want a healthy heart. They're good if you're if you're doing some weight management.
Then they're good for protection against diabetes and hypertension and improved digestion.
And it's got it's a really good source for vitamins, minerals, fats, and proteins.
And you know, all of this is what is found in pistachio, are all very good for your health.
Exactly. So, and it also reduces the risk of heart attack and heart disease. So So with that, you log on to our Facebook fan page.
Yeah, let them come back because okay. They're still taking a glance at the pistachios and how they are actually grown. So thank you very much.
So with that, log on to our Facebook fan page.
It is with the name of World This Morning.
Our Twitter page.
World This Morning, it's without a G, all right.
And the YouTube and Daily Motion
YouTube,
page.
It's World This Morning, and Daily Motion, it's World This Morning.
And the repeat is at?
5:11 p.m.
Have a wonderful day. We'll see you bright and early tomorrow.
Till the next time, 1, 2, 3, good morning. Thank you.